how it tells on my pictures as well.
But when you put it lower, the microphone, it has...
Okay, first time
this.
Yeah. This actually is now much better than the last measurements from what I can remember. So let's have a look. Have you done anything with the levels between the low end and the mid?
Yeah, we installed another capacitor.
Yes.
First we had the Western Electric, and what was the value? Two point something.
Okay.
I don't have it here, I think.
And that capacitor is in parallel with the low frequency, or?
No, it was in series with the, wait a moment.
Yeah.
It was, no, it was not in parallel with the low frequency.
In series with the 8 inch. Yeah.
It is in parallel with the Wharfdale and now this tweeter, but when you measured it last time, it was the same, but the value was less, as far as I remember.
Okay.
It was still in series with the, because the this one is connected in parallel with the low, but the low has in series the coil. The air coil
of how many Henry? Milli Henry. About, well, I don't know, I have to look for it. I don't remember exactly what was the value. But we have also to experiment with the coil. That's the final work we have to do.
Okay. Because the low end is...
What we discussed already this morning, a little bit too restricted.
Just like magic.
Yeah. You changed the...
I added the 10 dBs at 50 Hz.
Yeah.
And I added 5 dBs at about 10K.
Yeah.
And if we then do... Okay. 7.
That's nice.
Yes.
Goes up almost to 20. And goes down almost to?
If we are talking about within a window of... okay, hold on a sec. Do this and this. Come on. Active. Level shift. No shift. Normalize. And then we are definitely at plus, so good.
You adjusted the low to the same level as you did during the opera?
A bit more.
A bit more?
Yeah, but I know the setting.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I've kind of a filter from Nelson Pass, especially for open baffle. You can adjust the frequency ranges for both speakers.
Okay.
So, yeah.
Yeah.
I have the documentation in my office.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah. Yeah. Designed especially for open baffle speakers to make it without filter. You can you put the thing in between the piece of equipment, and then there are dip switches on it, and
then you can
adjust the frequency level, lift it or pull.
Yeah, that's exactly the same as but another thing that I've been thinking about is also the frequency system response electrical wise on your preamplifier and output amplifier.
Mm-hmm.
This roll at lowest frequencies, is it caused only by the speakers or?
Yeah, also by the amplifier. Yeah,
yeah. That's one of my main questions.
Yeah.
Because...
Case opinion is the preamp could be much better.
Okay.
And the same with the little Sun amplifier, as a prototype of push-pull with the same tubes.
Yeah.
And it is much better, I listened. It is only mono at the moment.
Yeah, okay.
But all this is gone. It is so natural.
Yeah, because if you push the level a bit too much, you can actually hear the amplifier working a bit too hard.
Yeah.
And that's my opinion.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what he said.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But anyhow, this is very interesting, and we know then also just by some magic, like not this one, this one. That's before and after connection.
Yeah, it's much better. Before of after, yeah.
So you can see it's only the lowest.
Yeah, the lowest is exactly what you pointed out. Yeah.
And the highest range is more correctly done with the resistor value.
Yeah.
Because doing equalization in the single path, it also introduces phase and that kind of stuff, you know.
So yeah, but the problems in the higher range were also caused by the Wharfdale. That was we were we reckon.
Yes.
One of the final things we said, we have also to have another look at the Wharfdale.
Yeah, because at this point the Wharfdale also is playing upwards into this construction.
Yeah. Yeah.
That creates something in that area also.
Yeah.
So here it's a lot of possible ways to go in experimenting.
Yeah. No, yeah.